Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 51 of Direwolf20's Forgecraft series. I'm plopping down an iron chest here, because I want to see what shows up in it. This will... ooh, redstone. That's what's probably going to go crazy. I'm basically didn't leave anywhere for items to go. And as a result, we have a lot of items back at our old base. So the new base has been fully migrated. Hello, old bases stuff. All gone. And before I leave, I want to go check in on the basement down here. So we were really low on power when I logged in, which, you know, makes sense, because I pretty much broke my whole item storage system last episode and didn't do anything about it. So when I logged in today, items were like, I don't know what to do with myself. And you know what? That's a reasonable thing for an item to say when they don't know what to do with themselves. Ooh, stone ladder, skeleton skull. Neat. So yeah, long story short, I fixed everything. I have a new set of crystals going. So this thing's at 9% left. It was around 20-ish when I logged in, but considering my whole base was without power, we were struggling a bit to manage. But now we're okay. So I'm just kind of waiting for this thing to go, but that's pretty much what I did. This thing was backlogged because it didn't have anywhere to put the excess stuff that you get from harvesting. So what is that excess stuff? Well, it's now going into the trash can. These things, the roots items. So added that, and now we're cool. So potatoes and hemp seeds being some of the big hitters that I'm going to need large, copious amounts of. Cool. And in here, this thing's running again. Cool, more stuff for things. This guy's cooking, this guy's cooking, and we're generating lots of gas, biodiesel stuff. So all the backlog of power is refilling itself, and that's good. One of my RF tools things was being derpy, the wireless redstone. I have to report it to McJD, but for some reason, as far as I know, this is the only thing outputting on channel 9, and the receiver down here was emitting a redstone signal, so the roots thing wasn't that thing wasn't running, so that's no good. Also, I can't fly at the moment because I had just enough power to fly, and I just placed a new chunk loader over at our new base, because in order to access the Ender inventory panel, we need a chunk loader at the base. So I couldn't access my stuff while I was here, so I put a chunk load over there. Lots of redstone. Holy cow, that's a lot of redstone. I'm just curious, like, how much we're gonna get. I don't even know where it's going or where it's coming from. This was T-Lope's design. And as a result, we have a large backlog of redstone, apparently. Again, no idea where it's coming from, but that's okay. Looks like there's one more thing to move. Let's pop back to our new base and see what's going on there. So my goal for today is probably, I don't know. I have no idea what my goal for today is. I probably have a goal, I'm just not sure what it is yet. So, this all is cool and stuff. I need that tape. Where's that tape? Do I have it on me still? Nice, packaging tape. That's pretty cool, actually. I really like this concept of, like, that's how you do it. And then when you place it again, it's groovy. Cool. All right, good deal. So that's been moved. So yeah, what am I going to do right now? I haven't entirely decided yet. Like, there's a lot of things to do if we want to move everything to our new base. So clearly one of the things that's still going on over here is redstone. Is that all of it? Okay, cool. So we're done. Nope. Okay, I think we've got the backlog cleared, and now plants that are growing, like the redstone plants over there, are just slowly filling in, so that's good. Also, these things were on, which was kind of a derp on my part, because, the level emitter that's detecting the storage control module thing, yeah, that is looking at inventories that no longer exist. If we look here, we can see pretty much everything has been removed. So let's rescan it. Yeah, and the only thing that's left really is storage scanner. That's right here. So yeah, that's obviously not going to work. That makes sense. So lots of things broken, but that's okay. So I guess first things first, figure out what I want to move next. I'm thinking... So in theory, if I did things smartly, in a smart-ish kind of manner, I could have a farm powering the whole base with the diesel generator. Wow, I landed right on with my wand, didn't I? Right on that ladder. So that's cool. And potatoes, are we low on potatoes? We are out-ish of potatoes. We're using a lot of things all at once here. Lots of stuff in use. This thing is still running, I presume. Yeah, because we have a net gain going on here. So we're using a lot of RF a tick. I think part of that is, or a big chunk of that at least, is this aversion thing, which we should probably like do some kind of automation so that it's actually only active, but active with signal. That's cool. So now we're hopefully no longer chewing up power, and that would be cool. So like we have a decent amount of power gen, but we also have a decent amount of power waste. So if we come over here, see how much more RF per tick we're generating? That's very nice. We also have like solar. So what we should really do is, so we've got like also like the solars thing going on, right? Which is actually not an insignificant amount of power, all these photovoltaics, and the water wheels, which are apparently working. Yeah, see? Plus 75 RF per tick. Okay, so the water wheels, even though they're not rendering, are actually working. So what I'd like to have at the new base, and I have to probably kind of wait for T-Love. I think it's supposed to be in the basement. I don't know if he's built it out yet, though. So is there a basement? So I don't think there's a basement. I think he said, yeah, I'll make a basement, but then he got distracted with me breaking and doing terrible things to his base. So he probably fixed all the derps that I did and then didn't get around to making a basement. So are there probs, Direwolf 20? Nah. Want to move power today. Let's see if he's going to join us. So, yeah. So my plan. So this thing is, that's okay. That should be cool. So I'm thinking if we move this, and we move. This. Come on. Wow, I keep teleporting through things. And move this room, right? I'd also probably like to have solars. I'd like to have all the power generation in one area instead of disparate areas. And then basically one dimensional transceiver that's sending power to all the receivers that would receive power. And then I think we'll be in good shape. But it looks like we're out of hemp seeds and potatoes, which is no good for anybody today. And we're now using, because our, I don't think, well, this is full now, so that's cool. This is running at about 22 RF a tick. Wow, that's significantly less than we were burning before. But we're also probably using power from over here-ish. So yeah, part of the problem is our power just isn't designed in a smart way. That's really where we're at. So we have to fix that. So let's come back in a minute when T-Love's on. And we'll start planning for our new power room that will be kind of well-designed. All right, guys, we're back, and T-Love has joined us. Heyo! So if I've done my math correctly, here to here should be 15 by 15. Haha! How cool is that?
So cool.
Right? And is this the center? 7... Oh yeah, look at that. How cool. Can you see that? Is that rendering for you?
What are we looking at?
Like the tape measure. Does it render for multiple players or no?
No, I don't see that.
No, that's a bummer. Because it's really cool what I just did. That's 15 by 16 because I did it wrong. But yes, you get the gist.
Yeah, you get the gist.
It's so cool. Yeah, I like the tape measure. I really like the chisel and bits tape measure.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
So shift click clears it, and I keep forgetting that. But yes, that does what I wanted to do. So putting away dirt for the time being. So that will be basically where the farming station goes. So whoosh, teleportation, and stealing farming station. So basically what I'd like to do is pick up and move.
Okay.
All right, minor little crash there, but T-Love has something to say. T-Love?
All right, chat, just so you know, I know you're gonna notice this, but yes, the farm will be uneven with the house. Get over it. You're gonna say in the chat anyways, but get over it.
Fair enough. All right, so I haven't decided exactly what I want to move first. I may not want to move the farm first. Maybe I want to move the generator first so that it's ready for when the farm is hooked up. How's that sound? Reasonable?
Sounds pretty good to me.
Do you have... All right, let's see, where are we at with all this stuff? We're out of potatoes up here. I gotta accelerate potato growth as much as I'm accelerating anything else, but... See, industrial hemp seeds were fine with potatoes, not so fine. What was I gonna say? Yeah, so I wanna move all this stuff. So it's a lot of things, and I'm probably just gonna go to the camera. Is the basement ready over there?
I kinda took the day off because I was extremely tired, so I didn't really get shit. That means a few things.
I can move the farm. That's fine.
We have the solar panels, which could last us, you know, decently farm. Just for right now, anyways, and then we can just up through the basement, of course.
Okay. So let's do this. Let's get this cooking. That'll be a minute. Let's get...
Definitely agree with the all-central energy.
So, alright, so we'll move the solar panels over, and that'll, like you said, keep the farm going at least.
Yeah, for at least now.
Cool. So, farm, you're gonna come with me. So you... are good. So I just want to kind of move this in an intelligible way, but I probably want to just, does the crafter retain its inventory when you pick it up? I don't know, but we're going to pick it up like that anyway. Insert priority 6, extract brown. Okay, that's how that works. And this is insert brown, extract green. Cool. So that should be fine. And then I'm probably going to want a ritual. Cool. So that's ready. And then I'll eventually want to move all these guys, but we'll get there. For now. All right, so let's see. If I just pop this here, will it start cooking? Nice. That's what I want to see. Only thing it doesn't do automatically. All right, so it needs a new hoe. So let's get undergroundish. Well, look at T-Love framing it out. Nice and fancy there, T-Love. Look at you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm impressed.
That's just basic.
It's fancy.
Fancy basic.
Fancy from Dyer's point of view.
Yep. Luckily, this is all nice and spacious under here, so you don't have to worry about setting things up too crazy. Find some way to fill it in.
So this will be... in and out, insert on brown, extract on green, always active. In and out, insert on brown, extract there, always active. So that should now have a hoe in there, and he should be cool and happy. Nice. Okay, good deal. And I'm going to borrow that hoe. Thank you. And, I mean, ideally we would have water there, but... cool. And then, that should be good. That's just the basic farming station up and running.
I'm bigger. Wait, what's that there?
What's that?
Being weird.
It's because the output's full, probably. That's probably the issue. So the next thing to move then would be all the barrels for all the item types.
Oh yeah, and I was gonna say suggest put the barrels right here on the side to make it like accessible for us.
If we wanted like to inside stacks. This room, like
in, yeah, inside along this little, wall. That works. Yeah, this little yeah, nice little aesthetics to it. I like that.
Okay, those drawers. Can you insert an extract from the bottom, or is it? I noticed on
yep.
yours.
Yes, you can. Yes, you
okay.
can. That's because I had the charge set barrels there before, and they can only insert top and insert bottom. So yes, you can insert and extract on the same thing. Actually, you could probably just go with the controller and just have one.
Right. Well, that was my plan, was a drawer controller.
Yeah, just have a drawer controller in the middle and then just have them here. And I think we can stack it at least two high so we can, just in case if we need any more area over there.
All right, cool. Back in a second, guys. I'm going to move all these and come right back. Okay, guys, we're back. Mr. T-Love?
Yes.
Did you finish your homework assignment?
Yep.
Yay, good job. Did you hook this up to item conduits?
Yep.
Nice. Good. No, I don't know that
you
did.
I said nope.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, I'm like, wait a second.
I said nope. Sounded like yep.
It did sound like yep. So there's our drawer controller. We're going to put this with this insert. We'll make this priority 5, meaning it's, you know, high priority for inserting, because I think this line is going to eventually be connected to our main setup.
Yeah, considering all the stuff is here,
cool.
having extra things just go here would be smart.
Nice. So capacitor, we want a medium capacitor bank for the time being. Right. So I'm quickly going to make a tier 5 capacitor bank and fill her up. So I'm going to do that. And then capacitor bank this dude. We only want one set of these for now. The rest can go away. I'll probably want conduits. And then back to the new base. So where should we put our solar panels?
Question is that.
For now, we're just going to put our, let me know where our solar panels should go.
Is this thing broken or something?
It's out of power.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to move it anyway, so just place it down. That's just going to give it energy for right now. I'll move it eventually.
Well, no, I want to put it where the solar panels will eventually be for real.
I don't have any idea where I can put them for real right now. That's what I'm blanking on.
Okay.
I mean, we could put them up top here, like on the tower, and have like a solar... like a solar thing going on where you can keep adding and adding. But that's, it's all the way up here, so I didn't.
I just put them somewhere very stupid, so I'm not going to do that. How about I just run them along here for now? Is that cool? Would you?
Yeah, that works. That works fine. Or, okay. That was weird. I had a really bad lag spike.
Yeah. So this is a temporary measure, obviously. But the plan will be you had a really bad lag spike and then you disconnected.
Yeah, am I on the server right now?
No, T-Love left the game.
Okay.
So we're generating 1200 RF a tick, which is not bad by any stretch with our solar panels.
Well, considering these are the vibrant, like, crazy ones, yeah, I would hope so. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine for right now. Yeah, that's really good, actually.
Yeah, it's ugly, but it'll work for now. Because
it'll do for now until I start making a reset up and stuff like that. It'll be fine.
Right. So the goal here is just to get our things. Now, the other thing I wanted to make real quick.
Do we have an extra octatic?
Well, that's what I'm going to make. We do now.
There you go.
How cool is that?
Oh, crazy. It's going to extend. Oh, boy. Oh, it just needs more seeds, though.
Yeah, no. And that's fine, because I have a Sigil of the Green Grove that should help remedy that.
Oh, yeah. Can we set up a new thing underneath this to add more growth?
I will in a moment. Okay. The only thing I might not be opposed to setting up would be maybe...
Also, can we move the saplings from here to probably the back area over here? Because the trees might mess with the build, that's all.
Yeah, so what's that? That is the east direction. So these are in the northeast. This
there
is
in
the southeast.
Goes. There we go, much better. Thank you.
You're quite welcome, sir.
And no worries about the trees derping up something by accident.
Yep. So I'm going to grab potatoes. Did you hook up any conduits to... on this side of things? Probably not, right?
Have not.
I'll just do this a little bit manually. But potatoes going in. And then saplings. That's a slightly larger farm than we had before.
Yeah. That's good.
But the plan is this is going to power most of our base, so we want the farm to be larger, right? Which makes perfect sense.
Yeah, the seeds, the wheat seeds. No, the hemp seeds. There we go. The hemp seeds. And what was the other thing we needed? Didn't we need...
potatoes.
Apples? Apples?
No, potatoes is what I'm using now.
Oh, potatoes can do it instead? Okay, good.
Potatoes, apples, pretty much anything that's a fruit, I guess. Like, so I think carrots would work too. Any hose in here? Of course not. I will in a second. Well, at least the hoe didn't have a lot of use left. Cool. So that should work. How's that look? From a height, it looks pretty good. All right, T-Love, I am back, and I think we're pretty much good here. The only thing left to do probably would be to hook this up to our main item storage system.
It just be too hard.
No. So in theory, I should be able to go in this direction.
Yeah. You are right below that. You're going here.
Ah, I see.
Also, I'm probably going to have to move that anyways if we're going to have that basement.
That's fine. Well, I mean, we're definitely going to want the basement, but... I'm helping you by clearing it out a little bit. But this should be the general path. So this is our matter receiver. That's our capacitor bank. This way. So if this is the cobblestone, then if I'm right, what we should basically be... So then we can have item conduits. Do we not have any more item conduits at the moment? Well, we will soon. We're also going to want the remote awareness upgrade. So this will only be insert priority 5, anything that already exists. Which means we should now have access to all the stuff in here from our main system. So for example, if I looked for apples, give it a minute to refresh, but it should, in theory, be available.
Six.
Hey look, 296 apples. That's cool. Perfect. And then, for example, oak wood. Nice, 6,200. Which matches, you know, roughly 6,200 oak wood. Nice. And these all have void upgrades in them, right, T-Love?
Yes, they should all have void upgrades.
Okay, can you...
The apples don't.
Neither does one of these, a couple... Well, the birch one doesn't really matter because we don't actually get that from here, but the left drawer doesn't here. Yeah, I would say just anything that's active in the farm, make sure it has void upgrades because we don't want that stuff going up into our miscellaneous junk chest.
Okay.
Cool. So that looks all good to me. And then in theory, if we were to grab potatoes and put them in here, they should automatically be extracted downstairs into here. So that if potatoes ever did land in the miscellaneous junk chest, nice. I saw it go up. It was there when I moused over it with Wayla. Rewind the video, you'll see it existed. But yes, it moves it out of the miscellaneous junk chest into that. So that is working. So I call that a pretty completed build. So now we've got the farm over here. We've got pretty much everything we're gonna need. I'm hoping that our hemp seeds and our potatoes, that this is like rapid enough of growth. If we need to do something to speed this up, then I will add ritual stones of growth, probably like over on this left side underneath the hemp area and underneath the potato area, and then we'll be in good shape. And ignore that alarm. That was my alarm reminding me that it's getting late. One more thing I want to do. Come on. There we go. Can we repaint things? I'm assuming I can do that. Yeah, we can. Nice. So, yeah, what do you think, dude? I think we're in pretty good shape here.
Great to me.
All right, so is there anything else that we really need to move that's item transfer worthy? Oh, you know what? I'm going to give you homework.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Go with that.
So if you go up to our old item storage area, you will find a few things in a diamond chest up there.
I see these few things.
Right. Come on. So those are items that are right now entering our system in an attempt to find their way home. So is this on insert? It is. So blaze rods are... I want your item to be priority -5. Because blaze rods are occasionally making their way over there, which kind of makes sense, probably based on how this is configured. How exactly do blaze rods... Ah. So that's priority 0. Now that's priority -5. So blaze rods shouldn't make their way in there, but like the infernal drops for the relic quarry stuff is making its way over there from our blaze farm. And you can see, like, mostly it's your redstone farm. So don't worry about the blaze one.
I can do that just by breaking the lily pads for the farm.
Oh, okay. So I wouldn't worry too much about your blaze farm, but the redstone we're going to have to do something about. So maybe between this episode and next, you can migrate your redstone ore farm to the new base.
Oh yeah, that comes to think of it. I didn't show you the cool energy thing before we ended.
Okay, well give me 1 second. I'll take a look at that. Okay. Alright, so before we wrap up the episode, which is super quick, what do you want to show me?
Back to the new base.
Okay. New base, go. So you came up with a neat way to do extra utilities power gen?
Oh yeah, it's so neat.
Okay.
Second floor.
Okay.
See this, right?
Yeah. Dragon egg?
Yeah. See how much energy it's powering?
No.
Well, for me, it's powering 500.
Really?
Yeah, one dragon egg equals 500 power.
Okay.
So yeah, just one of those. You're good.
Neat. Well, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, is the egg... You can get the egg multiple times, right?
I believe so. You have to respawn the dragon, though.
Yeah, that's not bad, but, I mean, that's 500 energy just for one. That's pretty good, not to mention daytime and nighttime.
Right. Okay, well, that's cool. I see you put a chunk loading ward up here. That's the one that was downstairs, right?
Yeah, that's the one that was downstairs. I just wanted to move it to make it look nice.
Okay, cool. Good deal. Works for me. All right, so wrapping up point for the episode. Your second bit of homework now is to get me a dragon egg.
Okay. I'll try my best to do that.
So you can have fun with that while you're streaming tomorrow. And for now, Darwell20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Take it easy.